Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, I am Professor Nasir Iqbal, Principal Government Degree Boys Science and Commerce College, Gulstan-e-Johar, Shaikh, Zaid Center. My subject is Zoology, and today my topic is Human Brain from Second Year Biology, Chapter Number 3, Coordination and Control. You know, brain is most important topic of this chapter, as well as from examination point of view in our intermediate examination system. I mean, in board exam, we have this question of 7 marks. There are 5 marks for description and 2 marks for diagram. First of all, we'll start from the definition of brain. How will you define brain? What is brain? We can define brain in these words. Brain is a part of central nervous system that performs coordination between different organs and parts of the body. Brain is a part of central nervous system that performs coordination between different organs and parts of the body. It also correlates the body with environment. देखिए, definition में हमने बात की कि brain central nervous system का वो part है जो body के different organs में coordination पैदा करता है और body और environment को एक दूसरे के साथ correlate करता है. हमारी ये जो बॉडी है, it is just like a machine that consists of different parts or different system, and all these system of the body work as a unit. To work as unit, there must be coordination between these systems and parts of the body. So brain is performing this function. That's why we have defined it that it is a part of central nervous system that makes coordination between different organs and parts of the body. And not only coordination between different organs and parts of the body, but it also performs function to relate the body or to associate the body with its environment. Some of the students usually think that brain is very simple. So if brain is simple, then note these words. If the human brain was so simple that we could understand it, we would be so simple that we couldn't. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि इंसान का दिमाग अगर इतना सिंपल होता जितना कि हम समझते हैं तो फिर हम बहुत ही सिंपल. Human brain जो है वो evolution की peak पर, जितनी एडवांसमेंट, जितनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हमें ह्यूमन ब्रेन में नजर आती है, ये किसी और एनिमल के ब्रेन में फंक्शनिंग के लिहाज से, स्ट्रक्चर के लिहाज से, डाइवर्सिटी के लिहाज से, उसकी कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी के लिहाज से हम नहीं देख सकते. सबसे ज्यादा एडवांसमेंट जो है वो ह्यूमन ब्रेन में ही हमें नजर आती है. लोकेशन क्या है ब्रेन? नॉर्मली हर एक स्टूडेंट जो है वो कहता है कि दिमाग सर में, लेकिन बायोलॉजी का जो स्टूडेंट है उसे इसकी एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन जो है वो पता होनी चाहिए। ह्यूमन ब्रेन इज सिचुएटेड इन अ बोनी चैम्बर ऑफ स्कल कॉल्ड क्रेनियम। ह्यूमन ब्रेन इज सिचुएटेड इन अ बोनी चैम्बर ऑफ स्कल कॉल्ड क्रेनियम। इट इज सिचुएटेड ऑन द डॉर्सल साइड। ह्यूमन ब्रेन जो है ये स्कल के इस बोनी चैम्बर में है, एंड दिस चैम्बर ऑफ स्कल इज कॉल्ड क्रेनियम। इट इज सिचुएटेड ऑन द डॉर्सल साइड। सो दिस वन इज द लोकेशन ऑफ ह्यूमन ब्रेन। नेक्स्ट, व्हाट आर meninges? The human brain is enclosed with three membranes made up of connective tissue. These three membranes, which are made up of connective tissue, are called meninges. The function of meninges is to protect the brain from different shocks and injuries. How these membranes protect the brain from different shocks and injuries? These membranes possess a space. There are spaces between the membranes, and these spaces are filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal fluid is a substance present in these space between the membranes, and this cerebrospinal fluid act as shock absorber. Therefore, it protects the brain from different shocks and injuries. Brain lateralization. The human brain is bilateral symmetrical because our body is bilateral symmetrical. Our brain consists of two equal parts, that is right and left. And you have listened that our right part of the brain controls the function of left side or left organs, and left side of brain controls the function of right side. How? Why? क्यों कहते हैं कि brain की right side left side को control कर और left side जो है वो right side को control कर? Reason, our brain consists of two lobes which are called as cerebral hemisphere, right lobe and the left lobe. These two cerebral hemisphere, right and left, they are internally the hollow structures, and their cavities are called first and second ventricle. In brain, the arrangement of neuron is opposite to the spinal cord. In brain, the peripheral part consists of the cell body or soma, while their axon run internally through their ventricle. Brain, I told you that the arrangement of neuron is opposite to the spinal cord. Cell body or soma of neurons are situated periphery, and axons are situated internally. The axon of neurons which are on the right side, they move towards left side. And the axon of neuron present on the left side, their axon move towards right side in this way. So axon of right side neurons move on the left side and left side moves towards right side. This is the reason that right part of the brain controls the function of left and left side of the brain controls the function of right side. And the place where these neurons cross each other, they form a band-like structure known as corpus callosum. Corpus callosum, the large bundle of neural fibers, myelinated axon or white matter that connect the right and left cerebral hemisphere. The peripheral part of cerebral hemisphere is called, peripheral part of cerebral hemisphere is called cerebrum. This one is the hemisphere specialization of left and right side. You can observe here that left side is associated with symbolic thinking. Right side is associated with the spatial perception. It is associated with language, and the right side is associated with oral pictures. Left side is associated with detail, and right side is associated with context. Left side is associated with literal meaning, and right side is associated with metaphor. This is contralateral division of labor. As I told you, the right hemisphere control the left side, and left side control the right side. How this mechanism is operated in your eyes? You can see here, your right eye controls the left visual field and left eye controls the right visual field as shown in this diagram. Next is the division of brain. Human brain is structurally is divided into three main divisions. What are these three divisions? Number one is for brain, number two is midbrain, number three is hindbrain. For brain, midbrain, and hindbrain. These are three main divisions of human brain. Forebrain is further divided into telencephalon and diencephalon. Telencephalon is the largest division of human brain. Telencephalon is the largest division of human brain. Let's start with telencephalon. As I told you that the forebrain or the telencephalon consists of two cerebral hemisphere, and peripheral part of cerebral hemisphere is called cerebral cortex. In forebrain, this cerebral cortex represents the largest area. It is divided into four lobes. The cerebral cortex is associated with the control and information processing center. Cerebral cortex, which is divided into four lobes. What are those four lobes? Number one is the frontal lobe. Number two, parietal lobe. Number three, occipital lobe. And number four, temporal lobe. Frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe, and temporal lobe. Frontal lobe frontal lobe is situated just behind this frontal bone. This one is a frontal bone of a skull. So the part of cerebral cortex which is situated behind this frontal lobe is called frontal bone, represent the frontal lobe. I repeat, the part of cerebral cortex which is represented or associated with this frontal bone is the frontal lobe. You can learn it, F for front, F for frontal. Then this part of the cerebral cortex represent the parietal lobes. Parietal lobes are situated just beneath this parietal bone of a skull. And I have learned it, F for front, F for frontal, P for piche, P for parietal, and P for parietal lobe. F for front, F for frontal, P for piche, P for parietal, parietal lobe. Then T, T for TT, T for temporal, T for TT, T for temporal. So the part of brain which is situated behind this temporal bone is the temporal lobe. And the last one is the occipital. Occipital lobe, these are situated just behind this occipital lobe. So there are four lobes: frontal, parietal, temporal, and occipital. What are the function of these lobes? What are the function of these lobes? First of all, the frontal lobe. Frontal lobe is most important division of brain because it is involved in decision making, plan making, intelligence, short-term memory, learning, speech coordination, and voluntary control of muscles. I repeat, frontal lobe, important division of brain. It is associated with intelligence, learning, speech coordination, short-term memory, judgment, movement, and muscle control. Whereas the parietal lobes, which are situated, parietal lobe, which are situated at the top and to the rear of the head, they include sensory cortex area. They are associated with the perception of weight, mass, density, recognition of objects and shapes, etc. Whereas temporal lobe, they are situated just above your ear and they are associated with your auditory functions. I mean the hearing. Similarly, the occipital lobe, which are situated on the back side, at the back of your head, they are associated with vision. They are associated with the visual perceptions. For occipital lobe, I usually say कि ये होते पीछे हैं, देखते आगे हैं. यानी location के लिहाज से back side पे हैं, लेकिन control कर रहे हैं आपकी eyes के functions, उसकी perceptions को. तो ये four lobes हो गए इसके cerebral cortex. और cerebral cortex part है किसका? Ilium. सेफ्रॉन का. तो फॉर ब्रेन में स्टूडेंट्स कितनी डिवीजन है, दो बड़ी डिवीजन है, एक टीलन सेफ्रॉन है और दूसरी डायन सेफ्रॉन है. तो टीलन सेफ्रॉन में हमने चार लोब्स के फंक्शंस को स्टडी किया. दीज आर द फोर लोब्स एंड देयर एरियाज इन्वॉल्व इन डिफरेंट फंक्शंस. यू कैन सी हियर इन दिस डायग्राम, दिस वन इज द फ्रंटल लोब, दिस इज पैराइटल, दिस वन इज ऑक्सीपिटल, एंड हियर इज टेम्पोरल लोब, एंड दीज आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ दीज लोब्स. यू कैन सी हियर द फंक्शन ऑफ फ्रंटल लोब, यू कैन सी द फंक्शन ऑफ पैराइटल लोब एंड द फंक्शन ऑफ ऑक्सीपिटल लोब, एंड दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ ऑडिटरी फंक्शन विच इज इन्वॉल्व विद टेम्पोरल लोब. सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ फॉर ब्रेन इज द डायनसेफलॉन. डायनसेफलॉन इज डिवाइडेड इन टू टू मेन पार्ट्स, नंबर वन द थैलेमस एंड नंबर टू द लिम्बिक सिस्टम. देयर आर टू मेन पार्ट्स ऑफ डायनसेफलॉन. यू नो डायनसेफलॉन इज द सेकेंड डिवीजन ऑफ फॉर ब्रेन. द फर्स्ट वन वॉज टीलेनसेफलॉन and the second is the diencephalon, and this diencephalon is further divided into thalamus and limbic system. Thalamus is situated just beneath the cerebral cortex. About thalamus, someone has written that thalamus acts as GPO, General Post Office. Someone has given the name switchboard, and someone has written that thalamus is a bridge between forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Why? Because thalamus is a part that act as relay center. It receives all the sensory informations from different parts of the body. Thalamus is a part of brain that receives all information, sensory information from different parts of the body, then transmit these information to the other parts of the brain, such as frontal lobe, parietal lobe, temporal lobe, occipital lobe, as well as cerebellum and medulla, etc. This is the reason thalamus is considered as relay center, switchboard or bridge between forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. It receives all the sensory information and analyze these information, then direct to the proper center of the brain. Thalamus is also a hollow structure. Its cavity is called third ventricle. The cavity inside the thalamus is known as third ventricle. Next is the limbic system. Limbic system is the second part of diencephalon. I again repeat, the forebrain consists of telencephalon and the diencephalon. Telencephalon consists of cerebral cortex, which is divided into four lobes, and diencephalon is divided into thalamus and limbic system. The limbic system in man consists of hypothalamus, pituitary gland, hypothalamus that controls the function of pituitary gland, amygdala and hippocampus. Let's see the function of these three parts. Hypothalamus. Hypothalamus controls or maintains the homeostatic functions of the body. All involuntary functions of the body are regulated with the hypothalamus. It maintains the homeostatic functions such as hunger, thirst, body temperature, pleasure. It also regulates the function of the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland, which was previously called as the master gland of the body and associated with endocrine function. So the function of pituitary gland are regulated by hypothalamus. You can say the control of pituitary gland is in the hands of hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is also called the thermostat of the body because it maintains the temperature of the body. When there is nutritional need in the body, then it initiates hunger. When you are going towards dehydration, it initiates the thirst. When the temperature of the body is increasing, it decreases the temperature. When the temperature of the body is decreasing, it increases the temperature of the body. So this is all about for hypothalamus. So we have learned that hypothalamus regulates the homeostatic function of the body. Hippocampus. Hippocampus is a memory processing center in our brain. You know, memory processor, as in your PC, in computer. The function of this hippocampus is similar. It is involved in the memory processing. It also stores the long-term memory. Next is amygdala. Amygdala is associated with the regulation of aggression, that is situation during fight. It regulates the situation during fear or flight. So you can say in different situations such as during angerness, during fighting, during happiness, during pleasure, all the natural feelings, natural perceptions are regulated by amygdala and it makes your body. It prepares your body according to the situation. You can see here the function of hypothalamus. As I told you, that hypothalamus lies below the thalamus, pituitary gland is attached with this hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is associated with eating, drinking to maintain the body temperature, and it helps or governs the endocrine system via pituitary gland. It also linked the emotions. Amygdala, these are two almond shaped neural clusters that are components of the limbic system and are linked to emotion and fear. Next part is midbrain. It's forebrain ke baad midbrain. Midbrain mammals including man mein ek bahut hi small area hai. Isko aap is figure mein dekh sakte hain. Ye yahan pe note kijiye कि ये thalamus है. इस thalamus के नीचे ये जो small area आपको नजर आ रहा है, ये midbrain. The small area situated beneath the thalamus and above the pons represent the midbrain. Midbrain is just like thalamus. It is also called as the bridge between hind brain and the forebrain, or relay center between the hind brain and the forebrain, because it deals with information like vision, odor, sensory, and information from a spinal cord that transfer to forebrain. What does it mean? That different sensory information which are transmitted from visual structures, which are transmitted from olfactory receptors, which are transmitted from other types of receptors, they usually pass through midbrain, then to the thalamus, will direct them to the related centers. This is the reason that midbrain is also called as the bridge between hindbrain and the forebrain, as I have written here that information from a spinal cord are transferred to the forebrain through this part of the brain. And students, the last part of the brain is hindbrain. Hindbrain consists of medulla oblongata, cerebellum, pons, and reticular formation. These are the parts of hindbrain. I repeat, hindbrain consists of medulla oblongata, cerebellum, pons, reticular formation. First of all, in the hind brain, let's see the location of these parts. This one is the spinal cord. And this spinal cord in the brain is connected with the medulla. Whereas cerebellum is situated behind the cerebral cortex, and this cerebellum represents the second largest part of the brain. I told you that our brain is a hollow structure. It consists of hollow spaces or cavities known as ventricle. There are two ventricles in the cerebral hemisphere, first ventricle and second ventricle, while third ventricle is situated in the thalamus, and fourth one is present in this cerebellum. What are the functions of different parts of the hind brain? Functions of different parts of the hind brain. When we see the function of different parts of hind brain, number one is medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata, posteriorly it is connected with the spinal cord, and anteriorly it is connected with pons. It performs vital involuntary task. Vital involuntary task, what does it mean? Medulla has respiratory center. In respiratory center there are inspiratory and expiratory center. So our breathing is controlled through medulla. Similarly, sneezing is associated with medulla. Medulla also regulate the heartbeat. So heartbeat is regulated by medulla. Breathing is regulated or controlled through medulla. Similarly, the cerebellum perform the function of coordination between muscles during movement. ये जो cerebellum है, movement के दौरान इसका function ये है कि ये हमारे muscles में coordination पैदा करता है, body को balance रखता है. So cerebellum is associated with balancing of the body. It regulates or coordinates the muscles, I mean the skeletal muscle, which are voluntary in action. Third one is the pons. Pons is also associated with muscle functioning, facial expressions, breathing as well as sleeping. Let's see the location of pons in our brain. This one is the pons area. Behind it is the medulla oblongata, and in front of this pons is the midbrain. The area of pons is surrounded by reticular formation. These are widespread connections. They are involved in arousal of the brain as a whole, and this form a reticular activating system. This reticular activating system present on the pons is associated with consciousness, alertness, function in sleep, and arousal from sleep. Means this reticular activating system keep us alert, conscious during different activities. It is associated with our sleep, and it also controls arousal from sleep. So these are three main parts of hindbrain. I repeat, the cerebellum, second largest part of the brain, contains a hollow cavity known as fourth ventricle, and it is associated with the coordination between muscles during movement. It performs balancing of the body. Medulla, that regulates the vital functions of the body such as breathing, control of heartbeat. It possesses expiratory, inspiratory center, and this pons that regulates the facial expressions, sleep, as well as it is also associated with the control of different muscles. Reticular activating system at the surface of pons is associated with consciousness, alertness, sleep, and arousal from sleep. Dear students, these are the parts and functions of brain. You have seen that the human brain is divided into three divisions for brain, in which we have studied the telencephalon and diencephalon, then midbrain, and last part is the hindbrain, where we have studied the cerebellum, medulla, and pons. Thank you very much.